Arabic learning must be easy. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Luay. Welcome to the sixth lecture of the language course on our channel, Academia Dimashq or Damas Academy. Here we go. What shall we do today? So, in this video, we learn about the following. Step number one is the introduction, where as usual, I will present some important information regarding the language. In the second step, we'll learn the sixth letter. And the last part of our talk today is grammar, namely the personal pronouns. The verbs in Arabic are three, so either in past, present, or future. There is no other times for the verbs. Past is the root. It's meant that the verb in the past is the basis. For example, the root in English is the verb in present. For example, the verb to eat or to learn. The point is you always start learning the verbs in Arabic in the past instead of in present in English. Different conjugation for feminine, like the words of adjectives, verbs, and pronouns are written with changes depending on which gender is used in the sentence. And finally, two is not a plural. In English, singular means one person, plural means two or more people. In Arabic, plural starts at three. So there is a different case for two. Our letter today is Ha. The Ha is written by drawing a horizontal line with a semicircle. There is also the explanatory video that clearly shows how to write the Ha. So, as we learned in the last letters in the series that the letters have different forms, the letter Ha also has three forms, namely, written at the beginning of the word, in the middle, or at the end of the word. But there is an exception for the second and third form, as we have seen in the previous lectures. The letters may be generally in the middle or at the end of the word, and still not have the appropriate form. We will see this in the following examples. And now the video. There is two ways to write Ha, and this is the first one. And now the second one. So both ways to write Ha are correct. Let's go on. Here we have two examples of the first form of the letter Ha at the beginning of the word. As simple examples, we have the noun habl, habl. So fatha on ha and sukun on ba and also sukun on lam. Habl, robe. The robe would be al habl, al habl. And the second example, the noun hisan, hisan. Hisan means horse. The horse would be al-hisan, al-hisan. So the lam of al-at-ta'rif in these examples is lam qamariya, al-habl, al-hisan. On the next slide, we have two examples of the second form of the letter ha, namely lahm, لحم. So فتحة on لام, سكون on حاء, and also سكون on ميم. لحم. لحم means meat. The meat would be اللحم. اللحم. So لام قمرية because the first letter in the word is لام. And the second example, بحث. بحث means search. The search would be البحث. البحث. So there is also لام قمرية here because the first letter in the word is ب. Next, we have two examples of the third form of حاء. مرح. مرح. So فتحة on ميم and also on راء and سكون on حاء. مرح. مرح means fun. The fun would be المرح. Also لام قمرية because the first letter in the word is ميم. In the second example, the word ملح. ملح. So كسرة under ميم, سكون on لام and سكون also on حاء. ملح means salt. The salt would be الملح. الملح. لام قمرية because the first letter in the word is also ميم. That was all about the sixth letter حاء. And finally, we come to the grammatical part. Today, we are going to take a look at some of the personal pronouns that we absolutely need to learn. The personal pronouns are الضمائر الشخصية. الضمائر الشخصية. I prepared it in the English way with the hope that it would seem easy to you because it's usually formulated very differently in Arabic. So, I will start with number one. We have the pronoun أنا. أنا. And means I. The next, أنت. أنت. Means you for singular masculine. For example, there is a man in front of you, then you say to him, أنت. أنت. The next pronoun, أنت. أنت. Means you, but for singular feminine. For example, if you have a woman in front of you, then you speak to her, أنت. أنت. The fourth one is أنتما. أنتما means also you, but for two persons. Just as I clarified at the beginning of the video, there is a separate case for two. For example, here, if you have two men or women in front of you, then you speak to them أنتما. أنتما. Number five. أنتم. أنتم means you but for plural masculine. For example, if you have three men or more in front of you, then you speak to them أنتم. أنتم. The next one, أنتن. أنتن means you but for plural feminine. For example, three women or more are standing in front of you, then you say to them أنتن. أنتن. The next one is هو. هو. And simply means he. Next we have the number 8, here. Here means she. If you talk about a woman who is not here, then you say here. So, she. In the next slide, we have here. نحن. نحن. and simply means we. The next pronoun is hum. Hum. It means they for masculine. For example, if you talk about three men or more who are not here, then use hum. Hum. The next is hunna. Hunna. And means also they, but for feminine. For example, this time if you are talking about three or more women who are not here, then you use hunna. Hunna. And finally, there is the pronoun huma. Huma. It also means they, but for two persons. For example, if you talk about two men or women who are not here, then you say huma. Huma. That's it for this lecture. To practice writing the letter, I have attached a PDF file in the info box below. You can print it out and then take your time to practice writing with it. I have also prepared a small quiz for you, which you can also print out in the info box below. And finally, in the third document, I summarized the content of the lecture. I hope that the presentation was simple and understandable for you. So, good luck and see you next time.